HDBaseT is a fantastic new signal distribution technology with huge benefits to the professional and residential AV markets. Getting your cabling right is key to a successful HDBaseT installation. So here's a few tips to help you get the very best results. It's still surprising to think that all these signals can now be simultaneously sent down just one single standard Ethernet cable. But in order to get the very best results from your AV system, ensuring best practice with your cabling is essential to a successful HDBaseT installation. So here's a few best practice cabling tips from the How-To AV team to bear in mind on your next, or maybe first, HDBaseT install. HDBaseT simultaneously delivers HD video, audio, 100BaseT Ethernet, and control signals and power over cable via the same single dedicated LAN cable. So you're significantly reducing the number of cables, cost of cables, and cable installation time and complexity. HDBaseT will deliver the full 5-play elements over Cat5e, Category 6 or 7 Ethernet cable. If your existing LAN cable infrastructure doesn't meet these specifications, new dedicated Cat5e, 6 or 7 cable needs to be installed. Also, the longer distance your cable run, the better grade your cable needs to be. So if you're running to the full 100 meter capabilities of full HDBaseT, Category 6 or 7 is recommended. In the same way as higher grade cable is recommended for longer distances, the same applies if you're running higher video resolutions. As the required resolution increases, so should the grade of Ethernet cable. If you're installing new LAN cable for your HDBaseT system, think about future-proofing. Though you may only be running 3-play or HDBaseT Lite functionality or lower resolutions today, things are likely to alter as technologies and custom requirements change in future years. So, if Category 6 or 7 cable can be installed within budget, you'll have leeway for higher bandwidth requirements at a later date. HDBaseT uses standard LAN cable infrastructure, and so, when terminating cables, the wiring scheme is no different. Use the standard 568B wiring scheme. Unshielded cables are, of course, susceptible to interference, so, as most LAN cables are unshielded, it's really important to keep them away from sources of interference, such as power cables, light fixtures, or transformers. If you're installing into an area suffering from high RF interference, shielded cable must be used to ensure successful results from your HDBaseT installation. Terminate your LAN cables with shielded connectors to further reduce interference. Although LAN cable is relatively resilient, try to handle it with a little care. Avoid rough handling, don't pull the cables too hard or too tight, and never fix them with staples. Damage or stress on your cables can significantly affect signal and performance of the system. Your HDBaseT equipment will feature a maximum recommended transmission distance. For full HDBaseT 5-play, the distance limit will be 100 meters. For HDBaseT Lite equipment, that maximum distance should be no longer than 60 meters. And finally, remember that HDBaseT uses standard LAN cables, so always apply the same best practices you would for a LAN cable installation in every HDBaseT cable install. To find out more, please take a look at our How-To AV channel or call our technical team for free help and advice. Thanks for watching and see you again soon with everything you need to know about AV at HowToAV.tv.